Well done for getting this far. You must be an absolute angle pro if you've got onto four-step angle chasing. And you're also going to need not just angle skills, but some perseverance and some good visual skills. So here we go. We're trying to find angle EDB. Where is angle EDB? Start at the first letter, E, travel to the second letter, D, and then to the third letter, B. So in that case, it must be the angle that you get there. Angle EDB. Okay, so that's the one I'm looking for, this one here. I ask myself, what would I really like to know? What other angles would I really like to know to find out that one? Well, to find angle EDB, I would really like to know this one here. Why is that? Because it lies on a straight line here, and I can use a fact that I already know. Okay, if you want to know that one, which other angle would you really like to know? Well, actually, I'd like to know two angles. I'd like to know this angle here and this angle here all at the same time. Why is that? Because I can see that there's a quadrilateral here, a four-sided shape, four-sided polygon, and I know that angles inside a quadrilateral add up to 360 degrees. Okay, so what angle would you like to know to find this one? I'd like to know this angle here. Why? Because there's an angle, there are two angles on a straight line. There's a straight line, that one and that one. They're going to add up to 180. All right, and if you want to work out B, this angle here at B, what angle would you like to know? I'd like to know this one. Why is that? Because there are some vertically opposite angles here. These two are vertically opposite. So I can use that fact there. Okay, we're getting somewhere. Let's go back to the start and work out this one. This angle here is 110 degrees because it lies on a straight line with this one. So I did 180, take away 70. This angle here is vertically opposite to this angle here, so it must be a 115. How are we going to work out this angle? This is the third step. These three angles added together, taken away from 360, will give us the angle that we're looking for. So 110 plus 115 plus 86 is what we need to do. And that adds up to 301 degrees. So they all add up to 301. So then if I work out 360 take away 301, that gives me 59 degrees. Why did I do that? Because all four angles inside the quadrilateral have to add up to 360. So that makes this one 59. And now to work out this one, which is the fourth step, I'll do angles on the straight line, 180 take away 59. Equals 121. So the angle that we were looking for was 121. Can you see the perseverance that we need? Can you see how you had to visualize things and see things four steps in advance? So if you're a good chess player, you'd find this kind of thing a doddle. And can you see how you need to know your angle facts off by heart? Right, well, that was four-step angle chasing, one of my favorite things to do in maths. Hope you enjoyed watching. Thanks, bye.